Now, the drug discovery technology company C4X has got its hands on a new piece of software which helps to identify drug candidates. The plan is for it to work alongside its current system, which is called Conformetrics, and helps users see the shapes of small molecules in a whole new level of detail and sophistication. Well, I'm joined on the line now by C4X Chief Executive, Dr. Clive Dix. Clive, thanks very much for joining us. First off, sounds a great piece of kit, this. Tell me a little bit more about how it works.
Okay, so the company has the aim of becoming the most productive drug discovery engine in the world. And to do that, we are looking at the fastest approaches to developing new drugs. We've recently acquired a technology called Taxonomy 3, which finds the best targets from genetic databases. So our starting point, the proteins we work on to target the small molecules against, are much more highly validated. And then we have our complementary technology, which we look at shapes of molecules and can then define the best possible shapes to make a drug. This technology enhances that capability by, once we've got those shapes and those molecules, we can refine them to make sure that they're absorbed into the body at the right level, and they stay in the blood as long as necessary for a medicine to work. So it's all about optimizing those molecules that we find by our other two technologies to make sure that they become really clean molecules that become better medicine.
And of course, the main overarching hope here is that it'll increase the likelihood of clinical success in drug trials, no doubt.
Yeah, absolutely. Everything we do is aimed at reducing the time and the cost of getting to the clinical trial, and then with the molecules we have being higher quality, that therefore they'll be less likely, they'll be much more likely to be successful in the clinic.
And so these drugs, they've been brought into the business on economical terms, I imagine. Just how economical, can you say?
I'll just say very. We're not giving away numbers, but basically this technology was developed over 3 or 4 years with a large amount of investment that, unfortunately, as a business model, wasn't going to work. So it went into administration, and we understood the technology as we'd been close to it all along and decided it was something that we should acquire. So we've acquired just the assets, and we've also employed a couple of people that we already knew and had worked with us on some aspects of their technology already.
And this type of analysis, it'll allow you to carry out, I suppose, do it in less time as well. So we're not just talking about cost, we're talking about a reduction in time and manpower here.
Time and manpower. And what we've acquired as part of this, which is just an add-on really, is we've acquired a virtual library of molecules of over 1 billion molecules, which we can screen against as starting point. So it gives us a good lift up when we start the studies as well, start the programs.
And you've said that your aim for C4X is to become the world's most productive drug discovery and development company. No doubt this will be nudging you certainly in that direction.
Absolutely. We're focusing on the discovery part, of course, at the moment. So once we've got molecules that are ready to develop, we'll either look for the best partners to do that with, or if we believe we can do it ourselves faster and better, we'll start doing that too.
Well, it's certainly an exciting time for C4X, and certainly plenty going on for investors to get excited about. But aside from this, is there anything else brewing that we can expect to hear about in the coming months?
Only that we will be pushing hard on our other technologies to bring new projects into the company. So we'll be starting new projects on a regular basis. So when we do, we'll announce those.
Brilliant, Clive. Thanks for the update. Good talking to you.
Thank you. Bye-bye.